The Philippine Interior and Local Government Secretary seeking clarification on the Davao Court's temporary protection order. On Tuesday, Davao RTC Branch 15 directed the police to cease and desist their attempts to serve arrest warrants to Kibuloy. Police were also ordered to remove their barricades surrounding the Kingdom of Jesus Christ compound. DILG Chief Benher Abalos notes a Supreme Court order has been transferred or has transferred Kibuloy's criminal cases to a Quezon City Court. Now, the Office of the Solicitor General is set to file a motion for clarification.
That is why we're filing cases to clarify. Number one, ano ba yung temporary protection order nila? No, definitely, yung pag-aaresto, tuloy-tuloy kami. But with reference to the barricades, to the barriers, kasi sa totoo lang, ito ngayon nakakatulong to protect life eh. Hindi ba? Kung papabayaan mo lahat at magkagulo, this is part of it na magkaroon. Ano, ika-clarify lang namin ito.
A desperate move. That's how Kingdom of Jesus Christ Minister Carlo Katiil describes authority search for their leader, Apollo Kibuloy. Katiil recalls the police brought several devices, such as heartbeat detectors, to find Kibuloy's possible hiding spots. But members are frustrated since the police have not left the premises even after a fruitless five-day search for the fugitive pastor. He also denies government officials' claims KOJC members tried to block authorities from serving Kibuloy's arrest warrant.
So, ano to parang desperate move kasi parang wala talagang nakita for 5 days. And they always accuse us that we resist. Wala pong resistance. Nakita nyo, paano ka mag-resist? 3,000, 4,000 mga polis nandito. 3,000, 4,000, paano mo yan i-resist?
KOJC's lawyer, Attorney Israelito Torion, accusing Davao Regional Police Chief Brigadier General Nicolas Torre of going on a fishing expedition for Kibuloy. He insists the PNP does not have authority to search a property that is not under Kibuloy's name.
We have here a situation really that they are on a fishing expedition and that they are even using certain men who are hooded as their alleged informant be a grant to conduct an omnibus search of a property not even owned by the accused. Not the answer to that is no. Simply because of the fact that the law does not grant him the authority to turn an arrest warrant to conduct an omnibus search on a property owned by another person.
Immigration officials continue to downgrade the visas of around 100,000 POGO employees following the total ban on the industry. Our correspondent Victoria Tulad is now on the line for more. Victoria, go ahead.
Stanley, the Bureau of Immigration has downgraded around 2,000 visas of Philippine offshore gaming operator employees since President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. announced the ban on this online gaming platform. During the Senate hearing on the budget of the Department of Justice and its attached agencies on Wednesday, BI Commissioner Norman Tansingco said they estimate POGO employees to number more than 100,000. Tansingco said these 100,000 employees were not given new IGL or internet gaming license. He adds they will accept the voluntary downgrading of 9G visas up to October 15th. Then by October 16, they will start the cancellation of 9G visas, leading to the termination of all operations by December 31, 2024. 9G visas are work visas that allow foreign nationals to be employed in the Philippines. Tansingco explained there's no more reason for these employees to be working here, so their working visa will be converted to tourist visas. He says the BI will allow them to settle all their accountabilities, secure clearances, and leave the country within 59 days. From the order of downgrading. He clarified that the 100,000 workers are different from those who work for unlicensed POGOs or IGLs. The BI is working with other government agencies to ensure that the 100,000 will follow the downgrading and eventually leave. Stanley?
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Victoria Tulad.
A progressive lawmaker urges Congress to strip the government of funding for its jeepney modernization program. That call by party-list Congressman Raul Manuel during the Wednesday budget hearing of the Transportation Department. Manuel says consolidated jeepney drivers and operators are still having a hard time, with many of them now deep in debt. The Senate previously sought the suspension of the program, but was turned down by President Marcos. Transportation Chief Jaime Bautista, meanwhile, said over 52,000 drivers have received aid from the government. He also gave the assurance that fuel subsidies will continue to mitigate the impact of the program.
Hindi ipaprioritize itong PUVMP or PTMP. Dapat nga hindi ito magpatuloy. So in the appropriate time, Sir Chair, isusulong ko pa nga na dapat ay zero budget. No? Dapat i-defund yung PUVMP or yung PTMP para sa 2025 hanggat hounded ito ng napakaraming issues.
Now, over in Japan, three people are missing as Typhoon Shanshan triggers landslides in the country's Aichi Prefecture. The mud and debris buried a family of five Tuesday night. Shanshan also putting air and rail travel in Japan to a halt. Japan's ANA airline has canceled 110 domestic flights, affecting some 4,200 passengers, while the flag carrier Japan Airlines canceled 80 of its domestic flights. Shanshan is expected to hit Japan's southwestern Kyushu Island over the next few days. It has brought up to 5.5 inches of rainfall so far. That's beyond Japan's average rainfall in August.